happy 50th birthday.
50? Golly.
Oh my gosh.
Man, I can't believe it. I just remember when he was 40.
Did you know that?
I think so. We've been together for 11, 12. Yeah. Anyway, what we really appreciate about Jared is just his sense of humor. He is just so funny. I call it childlike. She doesn't.
Yeah. Okay. But he is one of the funniest. You are one of the funniest guys that I know.
Funniest guys in the family. Yeah, yeah. Even on my side, I think you're
absolutely funnier than James.
Remember this one, so I can see you.
Okay.
I don't know why you're standing behind me.
Oh, okay. Because I like sitting behind you. Yeah. Anyway.
It makes her look shorter than me, which is just never going to happen. Excuse me.
Well, we have a tradition in our family.
We do have a tradition. It's a birthday tradition, and on your 50th, it's even more important, I think.
Absolutely. So what it is, you know, when Jim brought me into the family, he explained to me that on birthdays, the Hillier tradition is...
That, you know, if there's kids in the room, they may want to leave.
Yeah. So it's the Hillier tradition that when it, on your birthday, you get boned. It is a wonderful birthday tradition. It is. There's nothing quite like it.
And as you get older, it's, you know, kind of look forward to something like this on a birthday.
Like, once a year, we get boned.
Who knows? Yeah, that's exactly right. So we would like to we'd like to help in that endeavor and
bogey for your birthday.
Hopefully, Cammy's there. You know, that's right. And we're doing this, you know, a long distance, so it's a little different than being, you know, personally involved.
So,
which I want to be personally involved, but should we do it?
Let's go at it.
You're
going to
get phoned for your birthday.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, Jared. Happy 50th. Woo!
Hi. So, have to do a video for all those things that are wonderful about Mr. Jared Robinson. So I kind of put a list together, got a bunch of things, so I'm just going to read off of it. So, first thing, the hair, so much of it. I mean, I've got a lot right now, I've got about 2 months of growth, but that's not a lot. Another reason he's so great, he's tall. He's kind. He fishes, he jokes a lot, it's wonderful. Samson, hi, he's also a dad, he's so Ohio, he's also so New York, and he is so California, oh my goodness. Now the wonderful thing about Jared, he shares everything, he's so good. He's really, like, he's just good people. Two last things. One, he's Jared, and two, he's way older than I am, and that's probably the best part. Anyway, happy birthday, buddy. Can't believe you're 50. Holy crap.
Hey, this is an easy one. Why I want to pay a tribute to my man Jared. There's three really reasons. One is I consider you to be just an amazing human being, deeply rooted in the moral sense of justice. Obviously someone who lives their values on a daily basis. And that's a role model. Two is you always have something wise to say in the middle of conflict. And what I appreciate is those of us who want to run towards a fist fight, those of us who want to start a fist fight, you are the one who always says, let's examine all sides, and then supports the side we're on. And three, you're fun as hell to be around. Potty dog, and someone that I have considered a brother, a real brother, growing up and being together. So, dude, enjoy every bit of it. Bye.
Happy birthday! Happy birthday, Jared. Wishing you a wonderful 50th birthday and many, many more. So I am supposed to answer the question, why do you love Jared Robinson? First of all, for obvious reasons, we have the same last name. So you are my brother from another mother. And second of all, you have a fantastic afro. I mean, look at my afro, it's pretty cool, but yours is really, really cool. In all seriousness, I've loved you, Jared, since the day I met you. I love you because Cammy loves you and Samson loves you, and you guys have an awesome family. And I love that you're my little LA family that I can visit. And I feel like every time we hang out, it's always fun. It's always easy. And, you know, you're really good at detangling necklaces. That is another thing I love about you. Anyway, I'm wishing you so much happiness today and every day. And I can't wait to see you guys again and hang out in person. All right, much love, Jared. Happy birthday.
My top 10 reasons why I love Jared. Number 10, your improv skills are top notch. Number 9, you know every single song tune. Number 8, you crack me up. Number 7, you can jump super high. Number 6, you got moves. Number 5, you drink wine. Number 4, you can name more movie lines than anyone I know. Number 3, you can work a room like a pro. Number 2, you helped make Samson. And the top 10 number 1 reason why I love Jared is you make my sister happy. Happy birthday, Jared.
Happy birthday, Jared. So, what do I love about Jared Robinson? I made a short list. The first speaks to the first time that I came into his presence, and it's his presence. It's the fact that you're just so attracted to his personality, and he makes it so easy for you to like him. And I love that about Jared. Who doesn't love Jared Robinson? I don't think he's got an enemy out there. And he's just such a pleasure to be around since the minute I've met him to this day. And so so there's that. That was the first thing that came to mind. The second thing is that Jared is extremely skilled and talented at bringing groups of people together with his ability to make them laugh and get people on the same page and be a team player. And I've had the great pleasure of working with him in a team capacity with the Harker trip that we run every year with Academic Expeditions. And he's been on most of the trips. And when he's there, it's better and it's more fun and we laugh more. And there's something more authentic about the entire experience because he's on the team. And I've always been so grateful for his ability to just bring the best out in the teachers that he works with and the kids that are on his group. And he sets goals for himself every year and always surpasses them. And that's always like such a lovely thing to be a part of a team experience with him. The next thing I want to say about why I love Jared Robinson is watching him become a dad has been truly incredible. Samson and I share a birthday, so I met young Samps at the hospital after he came into the world on February 25th, bah, bah. And it's been awesome to, you know, see your friend turn into a parent. And I was a number of years behind you, but it's just been really cool to watch you help a small human develop their mind and their body and their spirit. And I love that. You know, I love watching you do that. And it makes me feel like what I'm trying to do, I don't know, strength in numbers, right? Super hard, but it's awesome, right? And so seeing other people live through that experience is like really incredible to see and to watch. And the last thing I wanted to say is I love Jared Robinson because he shows up. He shows up for his friends. He shows up for his family. And he always brings a level of, well, what I mentioned before, being authentic and being really present for those who he shows up for. And I feel like that's kind of rare. So those are some of the top reasons why I love Jared Robinson. Happy 50th birthday, friend. I'm sorry that I can't be in Savannah in person, although in fairness, I did not think I would be able to because I'm 9 months pregnant. but in this case, I feel like my FOMO is perhaps a little bit less because we're all having FOMO all the time. But I hope you have a wonderful 50th birthday. I love you, Jared. And yeah, just enjoy every minute of your birthday because you deserve it and you're so well loved. So sending you love from a suburb outside of Atlanta, because that's where we are right now. Mwah! Happy 50th birthday.
Hey, Jared. Coming to you from my bathroom, getting ready to go to work. I just gotta say happy birthday, number 50. Whoop, whoop. Gotta say I love you a lot, and you are my social guru. You can talk to anybody, anytime, any place, anywhere. I wish I had that, but oh well. Hope you have a great one. I love you. Give everybody a kiss for me, and have a good day. I love you, baby. Bye.
Jared, happy birthday, buddy.
Hey, buddy. Happy birthday. Welcome to your pandemic party. Sorry this was the best we could do this year, but one of the best things I love about Jared was he could always make me laugh, even going way back to the mid-90s in Johnson City. So I'm going to have a warm brownie for you, buddy. Happy birthday.
Yo, Jay Money. Happy 50th birthday, bro. Hope everything is going well. I hope that Cammy and Samson are doing well. You guys are having a great time out there. Yo, what can I say, man? You have been such a positive and optimistic force in my life, man. It's one of the reasons why I love you, man. It's why I keep you around. You know, that's why we're still bros. So live it up. Have a great time. Peace.
I've known Jared since we were all jumping our little one-speed bikes over ramps together, and he was always up for being in the mix and having fun. Over the years, I noticed that he developed a superpower. Jared's superpower is loyalty. You can count on him for being able to be whenever, wherever, and whatever you need. Whether your family, friends, folks at work, and really everything he does, it's topped off with an incredibly infectious smile for everyone, doesn't matter who you are. The world needs a man like Jared for at least another 50 more years. We love you, Jared. Happy birthday. Here is just a final note. I thought, I don't know any quotes that Jared usually says, but I thought I'd put a few out there that I could imagine him saying, and of course teaching his son over the years.
Hey Jared, happy birthday. Can't believe you're 50. So do you remember this? When you and Samson came out to California and did the optional course on bikes, that was so much fun. I can't believe how little he was. You're a great dad. I remember you balanced that, plus working, plus my team. You're so creative and fun. Loved when you guys came and stayed in our house, and I loved when I got to go to your house in Harlem and just see all aspects of you and your life. You're a good man, a good father, as I said, a good friend, and I really hope that your COVID 50th isn't awful. that you get to have some fun with the fam. But thanks for all you're doing. Thanks for being a good friend, Jared. Happy birthday.
Why do I love Jared Robinson? Whoever said I love Jared Robinson? I never admitted that to anybody. Anyway, I do love Jared Robinson. I've known you for a long time now, Jared, ever since I met you in that little tiny office in Koreatown in New York City, sharing a little office space with Hannah. Remember that? And we became friends and co-workers, and me sometimes your boss. So anyway, I just wanted to wish you all the best. I'm actually looking through the alley right now, and I can see your house. So I'm thinking about you and your whole family. Hope to see you soon. All my love. Take care.
Happy 50th birthday, Salt. I wish you a lifetime of happiness, prosperity, and good health. Quarantine, so hence the hat. Anyways, some of the things that I truly remember about you from back in the day, go Vols, is your ability to be so kind to all of us, our little tribe that we had going on at Morrell. You were the best at helping us maneuver through some of this stuff, and always supportive. And all of our lunch dates that we all used to have, I really remember your plastic hands and arms helping us out when we needed a salt shaker. Anyways, happy 50th birthday, man. I wish you the best.
Hi, my name is Marcus Keanu. Marcus Keanu Reeves. I'm gonna go with Marcus Reeves. Hey, Jared. I love you. Man, we've known each other for a long time. I first met Jared when we started rehearsing for this show called Keanu Reeves Saves the Universe. Now, I know that might be confusing because I'm Marcus Reeves and that was Keanu Reeves. But it was a stretch. I mean, I really had to work to be somebody different than I am right now. But we met. We sure did. We met right then. And at that point, this guy, this big tall guy, just constantly kicked me in the balls. In the balls! All the time! He wouldn't stop. I don't know. It's like it's written in the script or something. But it was all the time. And from that first point where I met him and he started kicking me in the balls, I knew I had to become this guy's friend. And I did. Because I didn't want him to kick me in the balls as much. And he didn't. He slowed down. He still kicked me in the balls, but he slowed down. And that's what real friends do. They don't kick you in the balls quite as much as strangers do. And during that time, the show that we performed, Keanu Reeves Saves the Universe, we realized that Jared is in fact my great 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 grandfather. Oh, unreal. But you know what? That point, we became not just friends, but family. We became family. And so, we decided as family that we should move in together. Because why not? We're in New York City, it's expensive, why not? So, we have Jared, this 6 foot, five-ish, handsome African-American man. We've got this moderately good-looking 6 foot, 1 centimeter Caucasian Midwestern dude. And we decided to throw in a little 5 foot something or other Jewish girl. And the three of us lived in quite harmoniously, something, but it was pretty nice. And at that point, we lived together for like 4 years. Unbelievable. When we first moved in there, well, I don't know, maybe it was a year later. So within the first year, I helped Jared build a loft bed. Unbelievable. Took him to new heights. He was like, 5 or 6 feet off the ground. Something like that. I just remember when he was sleeping, he was really close to the ceiling. But we took this loft bed and built it into the living room, which really became his bedroom, but it was still kind of the living room because it was only separated by a curtain. And it wasn't like an iron curtain that you couldn't go through very easily. It was like just a real nice, easygoing curtain. And that's what we did. I'd come into the curtain, I'd say hi, we'd hang out, we'd watch movies. He'd come to my room, say hi, we'd hang out, we'd watch movies. Yeah, we like movies. He's cool like that. Anyway, you know, I just wanted to say I love you, Jared. I almost called you Darren. Because you're my granddaddy. You're my great-great-great-great-great-great-granddaddy. Anyway, Jared. 50 years. The big 5-0. I don't know what that means since you're not in Hawaii, but 5-0. Alright. So anyways, I just wanted to wish you a big 5-0. And I love you, man. I love you.
Hey, Jared. Dude, the big 5-0. 1970.
So we were just thinking about the really cool things that happened in the 70s, like floppy disks and post-it notes.
Instamatic cameras and Walkmans, hacky sacks and Ruby cubes.
Bell bottoms and fringe jackets, disco balls and Saturday Night Fever.
Twix and the Big Mac.
And you, my friend.
We wanted to share one thing about you that we love the most. But that became a little tough.
Because there are so many things to choose from.
That's right. We could have talked about your hilarious sense of humor, so many comic clubs to visit and so little time.
Your positive attitude and your joy of life.
Your awesome dadness and what a wonderful role model you are for your son.
What I especially love is your interest in so many different things and your willingness to share those things and your enthusiasm when you do it.
And for me, and what kind of permeates everything that we've talked about, that we love about you, is that you are a good person. You're caring, compassionate, and kind. And that is reflected not only in how you deal with your family and your friends, but people that you meet every day. And frankly, the entire world, because you care about those that are disenfranchised and dispossessed and discriminated against. And that's what makes you really special. And that's what I love about you. And that's what makes me really proud to consider you my son.
We love you, Jared.
Happy birthday.
Hi, Jared. Greetings from Brooklyn. I have known you for a very long time, and I love you very much for many, many reasons. This is the year I turned 50 as well, and my plans have changed as well. So I've decided not to turn 50 this year. So I love you for turning 50 when us lesser folk decided to stay 49 for another year. I miss you all very much, and I'm sending you all my love. Bye.
Happy birthday, Jared. Happy birthday, happy birthday. You are such power and light, such a gift to this world, and such a gift to me. Have a magical day.
Take job, but not my friends, you see. And here I am, just waiting for this storm. On the beach there with all my friends. The sun's so hot and the waves in motion, and everything smells like suntan lotion. The ocean and the girl so sweet. So kick off your shoes and relax your feet. They say that miracles will never cease.
Jared Robinson, happy birthday, brother. Happy birthday. You're 50 years old. Welcome to the ranks. I'm going to have to send you a membership card. You're now in the ranks of Vicks Vapor Rub, Aspirin, Maalox, and Melanta, and of course laxatives and other sundry things to keep life pleasant and on the up and up. So I just want you to know I love you. I'm happy you've made it to be 50. So many of us brothers haven't made it that far. You know, we were fighting the popo all the time. So remember, like we used to say in the service, keep your head down, keep your powder dry, and don't let anybody beat you at three-card Molly. And I'm very proud of you. And when I look at Samson, I see a reflection of all of your influence on his life and helping him in the formative years. And there'll be more of that to come in the future, I'm sure. Woodworking, that I understand you like to do woodworking stuff. And so I'm gonna send you an Amazon gift card so you can get what you want off of Amazon, because they have good deals too. I don't know how to do a Lowe's gift card, so that's what I'm gonna send you for your 50th birthday. Send you $1 for each year, so you get a $50 gift card. So anyway, I look forward to talking to you many more times in the future. And call me sometime, Negro. You don't ever dial my phone number. I'm the one always calling you. So anyway, that's it for my grooming coaching. So I look forward to many more years of conversation with you, bro. Peace out. Love you. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to Jared Robinson, one of the funniest, most creative guys I know. Cammy asked me to send you this video to remind you that you're old. You're 50 today, and that's old. In case you didn't remember you were old this morning when your creaky-ass knees needed to lever those long-ass legs, you're old. In case you didn't remember you were old when you were yelling at those kids to get off your lawn, you're old. In case you didn't realize that you were old when you had Samson hook you up to this video chat or any other video chat, you're old. In case you didn't realize that the kids in America born when we took our trip to Zimbabwe are gonna vote in the next election, and half of them are gonna vote for Trump, you're old. In case you didn't remember that three quarters of the sci-fi that you grew up with and loved takes place before your 50th birthday, in case you forgot that your friends all look like this, you're old. We love you.
Dr. Robinson, Jared Robinson, why do I love my brother? Because he is my brother par excellence. Jared is an amazing individual. And I can say meeting you at HAI was definitely one of the highlights of my time there. But most importantly, when I was at one of the lowest times in my life and really learning to deal with myself and completely embrace all of me, and it really didn't feel good about myself, Jared was able to speak life into me, you know, and to really, really, really counsel me about. And in addition to just bringing all the brothers together to sit around the table the night, he's just a wonderful person. And I really do love you. Happy 50th birthday, bro. You don't look well, you already know that. Cammy, I love you too. And I love my nephew. All right, happy birthday.
I love you, Jared, because you are the most open, nicest guy, and you are so supportive of Cammy and all of her friends. We need more men like you, Jared. Happy 50th.
Hey, JJ. Welcome to the club. Big 5-0. Happy birthday.
I love your humor.
I love your chicken dance.
I love your affable personality.
Happy birthday!
Well, you had to create a big world event to celebrate the big birthday. Now, I know you would have preferred everybody got to go into a big festival to celebrate the birthday versus having to stay at home, but sometimes that's the way the world works. Welcome to the other side. I wish you all the happiness, joy, friends, and family that can be mustered during this celebration week. Take the whole thing. Take the rest of the month. And enjoy. Have a really great birthday.
Of the countless things that I love about Jared, one of the most important is his genuine, heartfelt, unconditional kindness. The example I have is the day that I clumsily fell on my face on the sidewalks of New York near their home. He gently and kindly walked me down to an urgent care clinic. On the way, we were clumsily accosted by a policeman who was questioning this tall, handsome black man hanging on to this beaten up little old lady. He very graciously explained to him he was taking his mother-in-law to get medical attention. And we went on. I love you, Jared. Happy birthday.
Hi, Jared. Wishing you a happy birthday from the East Coast. Today, we're all sharing things that we love about you. And for me, it's the fact that your support of me and what I do for a living has never wavered. Even when I don't think I can do it, you certainly think I can. So that you will never know how much it means to me. You are such an integral part of our family, and we all love you. Also wanted to share that you have some incredible talents, like this jeté that will forever be one of my favorite moments. All right, I love you. Happy birthday. Bye.
Hi, Jared, it's Skylar. I just wanted to say that I love how funny you are and how positive you are and how much you love our family and support each and every one of us. And most of all, I love how much you can turn one simplest and smallest thing into something so much bigger and put it in such a different perspective. And my example of this would be when you gave me a map of Cleveland, Ohio, I think it was, and we had this long talk about it with some of my siblings, and I ended up crying, but it was a great conversation, and I will always keep it close to my heart. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I miss you, and I love you. Have a good one. Bye.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jared. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, big guy. Welcome to the club. It took you a while. Glad to have you.
We wish we were there with you. We're sending all our loves. Happy, happy birthday.
Why do I like Jared? Love. That's right. Why do I love? Because he's funny. I mean, that's, you know, that's all that really matters, right? That he's funny. He's funny. Hilarious. Chilling on the grok. Ask about that one. What, you need more than that? Okay, good friend, apparently decent fisherman. Great dad, I hear that. That's awesome. That's always a good thing. And he's funny. Something like that. I don't know, wherever the hell you are, or whatever the hell you're doing, I hope you have a great birthday. Miss you. Be good, because people are good to you. I mean, that's not the only reason to be good. Just be good. Darn it.
Happy birthday, Jared. Big 5-0. Big 5-0. Too bad we can't be there, but this is just as good as it gets. We love you. We miss you. You're a good father. Hang in there. We love you. Have a good one.
What I love about Jared is how you say yes to pretty much almost anything. You're so open to new things and new experiences, whether it's a new restaurant, a new friend, a party, a neighborhood, a new sport, a comedy show, a new city, moving to Santa Monica. I wish that I could be as open and as a yes person as you are. I hope to bring more of that into my life. I love that about you. I love you. I'm thrilled that you guys are here and we get to see you all the time, although not now because coronavirus. And I think you're an inspiration. Happy birthday, Jared.
What a year this is turning into, am I right? Happy birthday, my friend. I wish I could come over there and give you a big birthday hug myself, but we will settle for this. You're a really special person, and you mean a lot to me, Jared. You really saw me at my worst this year, and in that very moment, you told me you loved me, and that will be in my heart forever. The feelings are mutual, while I know this is not how you planned celebrating this milestone birthday, we're going to get through this, and we will celebrate properly sometime down the road. Until then, I know how lucky your family is to have you with them during this difficult time, and I'm sure they're letting you know how appreciated you are. You're the best, you really are, and I hope I get to see you in person real soon. Take care, man.
Happy birthday, Jared. I don't even have one example of how you've helped me, because you've helped me so much in so many different ways. I'm so lucky to have an uncle that gives such great advice as you. I love you so much. Happy birthday. Have a great day.
Yes, brother. Why I love Jerry. Jay, I love you because, I don't know, we've been friends for almost 20 years. And I know without a doubt and all certainty, no matter what the situation, the day, the time, circumstances, the idea, the philosophy, no matter what it is, I know that I can reach out to you and you'd be fully supportive without judgment, understanding, patience, fully present, with your wisdom, with your heart, with your spirit. And I love that about you. And it's never wavered, brother. Thank you. Happy birthday. Go, 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 go.
Hi, Jared. It's the Joseph from Sam, Colorado. We just wanted to wish you a happy 21st birthday.
Sounds right to me.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, anyways, hopefully when all this is over, we can celebrate together and have a really fun day. So, all right.
Happy birthday.
Well, happy birthday. We love you.
So, I heard it was somebody's birthday. And this is a tribute to him. So, let's just dig a little deeper. I absolutely adore Jared. More than love him. I would kind of say I've been in love with him for a long time. Maybe 30 years I've been in love with him. Since I first met him, I can't. We kind of crossed paths before that in high school, and that when he used to beat my ass in hurdles, I fell, he won, that kind of thing. But through acting classes, going through all that stuff with Lucinda, with the one with crazy eye, and nights of drinking Labatt's and Black Label and listening to Rush and our common, you know, bonding of that, I don't know, strange roommates that like to relax their toes at times. And, the big thing is that you were always a true friend, no matter what. Always, regardless of anything. You always gave me the worst advice. I mean, the best advice, I think, always. For family camping trips, having race discussions with my mom, which, you know how great that was. Going through a strange breakup while camping and drinking a slow gin fizz, which was a bad decision. That was a bad decision. I shouldn't have done it. But, you know, it was great at the same point. The big thing that I keep coming back to throughout my entire life is that you have always been an unendingly gracious friend and has always been there for me. And I think you've been there for me more than I've been there for you. And I absolutely cherish every second. You're there through my first marriage and how it ended and all of that. And throughout life, you travel in and out of so many people's lives. And time is irrelevant when it comes to friendship. No matter what, you've always been there. Period. And that is something that I can't say about a lot of people. You mean a lot. I hope you have the greatest birthday in this crazy, tragic, insane time. Look at me, my unwashed hair. Am I ready to join the Bee Gees? I guess I still have it. I'm trying to go and facial hair. I finally get puberty. So, love you, man. And, I'll finish with a quote. So, take yourself a friend, keep them till the end, whether woman or man. It makes you feel so good. So good. Thank you, Jerry. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Namakwala. I loved watching you jump all those hurdles at University of Tennessee. Thank you for making me laugh. And with all your attention seeking and your rat tail.
I love you, Jared, because you're really generous and because every time you come, you give us a gift and you're really nice about it.
I love you, Jared, because on Christmas you sent us that microphone that annoys my parents a lot.
Jared, first of all, happy birthday, the big 5-0. But I just wanted to tell you that, you know, the second I met you, you felt like family. I heard all the stories that preceded you before I met you, and you just made me feel like I was part of the family all along, and so appreciative that you took on the role of being the godfather of these two over here, and wish we were closer so we can enjoy a great bottle of wine together and lots of laughs.
Yeah. He's funny, I guess. The only man that ever made me almost pee myself in public. Just all around good guy, showing up for 21st birthday parties and, you know, letting brother sleep on his couch when he got kicked out of his girlfriend's apartment. All that good stuff. You wear a good fro, keep it up. Got good facial hair too. Got that working for you. Happy 50th, bro. Enjoy. Here's to 50 good more. Peace out. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Hey, Jared. Hey. Happy birthday. Sorry it's during a quarantine, but I hope all is good. We'll have to celebrate in the future. And there was Logan running around in the background.
That's right. He's practicing his basketball. Say happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, man. Hope you have a great one, even though it is what it is.
Happy 50th.
We'll talk to you soon.
Hi, Jared. Happy 50th. When I first met you, I thought you were a pretty funny guy. And so many years later, you still are. Have a happy 50th. May you have 50 more. Stay safe. Take care. Love you. Happy 50th. Bye-bye.
Hey, Jared. Happy birthday, buddy. Just wanted to say a quick hello and happy birthday to you. We all had something to say, Grayson.
I appreciate you because you make us not feel left out, and you make us feel happy, and you try and be the best uncle you can.
I appreciate you because you're really fun to be around, and you're funny when you talk, and you like big and warm hugs like Olaf.
What I love about you, Jared, are so many things. First and foremost, you are my outlaw. We are Anderson Outlaws, and we always will be. So it's great to have you as a partner in crime all the time. And I love all the conversations we get to have and the connections that we have through our kids and through our family, but also this big, wonderful family, the Andersons. And you bring so much joy and laughter. And I think the right word is, I don't know, introspection. Like, I love having conversations with you and getting to hear your thoughts and perspectives on so many varied topics. And you are a true Renaissance man in that way. So, happy birthday. I look forward to many, many more birthdays.
And I just want to say, I'm so glad that you're part of this family, buddy. Just having you around and having another strong dad and someone who's so involved as a husband and as a father. It's great for me to see, and it's nice to have a partner in crime in that sense. And like I said, I'm so glad that you're part of this family and that you get to be part of all the things that are important to us. And having you guys close by and getting to spend a little bit more time, albeit sometimes with a quick nudge and a reminder to just back all the way out, all the way out. But anyway, we just wanted to send this message to say that we love you and a happy birthday to you. And don't touch my wine. Woo-hoo! So it's Jared, and since I think you're turning 50, so hopefully this plague is treating you a little bit better than the past ones that you've lived through. All right, man.
We love you
very much.
Happy birthday.
See ya.
Hi, Jared. Why do I love you? Because you are so smart and so charismatic and so inspiring. You've inspired me to throw caution to the wind. In fact, I'm going to throw caution to the wind right now and sing you a song.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jared. Happy birthday to you.
I love Jared Robinson because he taught himself to swim and entered the Toronto Triathlon, thereby inspiring me to get over my fear of open water and swimming in the lake myself. I love you, Jared. Happy birthday. I am so thrilled for you to be my friend.
And I love Jared Robinson because, like me, you rock.
Happy birthday, Jared. I'm so, so fortunate to be among those who are celebrating this milestone birthday with you today.
when I think about what I love about you, I think of kindness and I think of joy and I think of how you bring that to every single person you meet and every single person who you call friend. And I am so, so glad to be among those. I think the best way for me to explain the story of why I knew that those things were who you were from the very beginning is a little bit after the very first time I met you. I think this is probably 12 years ago. It was a beautiful day. I was in Madison Square Park with Leo, and he was kicking a soccer ball around an empty fountain. And I looked the other way, and the next thing I know, you are there kicking a ball with Leo. And we had just met, so it took me like 12 seconds to be like, oh, that's Jared. And look, he's playing with Leo. And somehow Leo knew this was an awesome person to play with. And I watched the two of you kick a ball around this fountain for probably 5 minutes before I walked up. And I said, hi, Jared, thanks for playing with Leo, who had a smile on his face, and you had a smile on your face, and I had a smile on my face because I loved watching the two of you just shoot the ball on a lovely spring afternoon in the park. And I think it was then I knew that you just find fun and joy and all of the good things in every single interaction. And I think after that, I just knew that you were a great, great person to know. And I am so glad to be your friend and have to been in your life for all these years. So just wishing you the best of birthdays, even though this one is in quarantine, there'll be many, many more out of quarantine. And I hope to be able to celebrate with you at some point in person. So much love and be well. And I hope to see you very soon. Bye-bye.
Birthday blessings, Jared. Here is to you on this milestone birthday. I am pulling you a gemstone card for my gemstone deck. Thank you for always giving us your love of life, your passion, your energy, your joy, and thank you for always making so many of us, including me, feel seen, heard, safe, and loved. Okay, I pulled Garnet for you. And Garnet is a beautiful, beautiful stone, and it really helps with this, I got this attitude. So I think this should be your motto for the next 50 years. I got this. You give so much to all of us. Lots of love, Jared. Happy, happy.
So it's a repeat after me, remember?
Repeat after me.
Okay, so. Seven is swimming in the water.
Swimming in the water.
Eating is suffering.
Eating is suffering.
Why did he
float?
Where did he go?
The moose! The moose!
Not swimming in the water!
Not swimming in the water!
Not eating his supper!
Not eating his supper!
Where did he go?
Where did he go?
He decomposed!
He decomposed!
Got the mic drop!
Mic drop!
Thank you, Cleveland!
Happy birthday, Jared.
Happy birthday.
We love you very much.
Hope you have a great day.
Stay safe.
Welcome to your sixth decade.
And today our first song will be Party Time.
Party Time. Everybody ready for Party Time?
Birthday, Jared. When I think of you, I always smile. And I think of a poem that my dad really loved, and I think you would like to. In fact, you'd have liked my dad a lot. Poem is success. To laugh often and much. To win the respect of intelligent people and the affection of children. To earn the appreciation of honest critics and endure the betrayal of false friends. To appreciate beauty. To find the best in others. to leave the world a bit better, whether by a healthy child, a garden patch, or a redeemed social condition. To know that even one life has breathed easier because you have lived, this is to have succeeded. And by every major, Jared, you have succeeded. We love you. Happy birthday.
Okay. Hey, it's time for the video.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, dear Jared. Are you really 50?
Are you sure?
Are you sure you're really 50? You can't be 50. Okay, well, if you're 50, happy 50th 50 birthday. Bye.
Hey, Jared, what's going on? Happy birthday, brother. Listen, welcome to the 50s Club. Things to remember, don't forget your AARP card. Sign it, get you a lot of good discounts. Man, sorry I'm not spending your birthday with you, but just wanted to let you know I'm thinking about you, wishing you a happy birthday. And once the world opens up, let's get together so that way we can celebrate the right way. All right, take care, brother, and enjoy.
Happy birthday, Jared.
We hope your next 50 is as wonderful as your first 50. You rock.
Woo-hoo! We love you and miss you.
Bye. Hey, Jared, this is Jerry. I understand that you're about to be 50. Well, I wish I could relive 50. Your perspective may be that you're getting older, but my memory of 50 was I was reaching the peak of my abilities. I had a great 3-year-old grandson, and I was building the Oakland Federal Building at the time. So things were going great. And I finally reached an age where I actually knew what I was doing. So I think that you're slightly ahead of the curve on that regard. And that, along with that winning personality of yours, 50 going forward should be some great times, not just for you, but for the continued growth and success of your family as well. So enjoy 50. Look at it as the next chapter of great accomplishments, and celebrate with appropriate social distancing. So have a great time. We love you, and look forward to actually seeing you in person, and maybe having a beverage to honor this day. So take care.
Happy birthday, Jared.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
We think you're the best. We are so happy that you're part of our school community and that you're just part of our friendship group. We're thrilled that you and your family moved here. And we just adore you, and we just think you're the coolest.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And, you know, it's been a super pleasure having you as a buddy. And we really look forward to getting out of this whole COVID thing so we can go hang out and, you know, have some beers or play pool or whatever. And but, you know, really hope you're doing well, and I hope you're having an awesome birthday today or Wednesday. All right. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Jared. Happy birthday to you. This is the 50th birthday that you will never forget. It's one to tell your grandchildren about. And the reason that Dick and I love you is you're a fabulous dad. One wonderful fisherman.
I don't know about that. I've never seen a fish.
Funny guy.
That's for sure.
Wise, knowledgeable, one of the tallest people I know. We love you. Happy birthday.
Bye.
All right, let's give it a try this way. Reasons that I love Jared. Well, first, he's from the rubber capital of the world, Akron, Ohio. I met him in freshman anthropology intro class at UT Knoxville. And even though he had a rat tail, we still remained friends. He also had a giant car in which he transported us to dance clubs and dance parties, and also took care of us after those dance parties every now and then. He coined the term sleep fest, ironically, the name for a sleepover at which there were only women, except Jared, the only man invited. He helped celebrate my 21st birthday, and most of all, he's always been a great friend, a good listener. He's helped pick up pieces after breakups, and I'm so excited to help celebrate your 50th. Jared, happy birthday. Cheers.
So, one of the reasons, Jared, you're one of my favorite people in the world, besides being warm and hilarious and fabulous and just so absolutely caring, is that you shared with me a wonderful piece of wisdom a few years ago when you and Cammie and Samson were visiting. We were sitting out in the backyard, and I was just mentioning to you how often when you're getting to know someone at a party or, you know, you've never met someone before, and they often only just ask you, well, what do? And sort of just narrows a human being down to what their career is. And I always really hated that and dreaded it, especially if at that moment in life, I didn't know what I was doing. And you said you totally understood, and you had a much better question that you like to ask people, which is, when you meet someone, instead of asking them what do, you like to ask them, so what's your story? And since that day, Jared, every single time I've met someone new that I didn't know, at a party or a gathering, I always ask them that, and they're always taken aback because they don't know, often know what to say, but you get such a wide range of wonderful responses and get to know sides of people besides just what their occupation in life is. And so yeah, that always meant a lot to me, and I use that question to this day. So anyways, I can't wait to party with you again when this whole thing is over, and I hope you and Cammie and Samson have a fabulous, fabulous 50th birthday. Happy birthday, Jared! Love you! Bye!
Hi, Jared. Happy birthday. It's me and Kai and Ted here with us. The girls wanted to do their own happy birthday video, so Kai's going first with me.
One thing I like about Jared is that he always makes me laugh and smile, and he's really funny.
Alright.
Happy birthday, Jared.
Yes, happy birthday. And so I did write out my message because I wanted to make sure I got everything in there that I wanted to say. So when we think of a couple things that we love the most about you, there's a couple things that come to mind. The first thing is your amazing ability to offer advice and insight and wisdom without ever having to be asked. I can tell you there have been multiple times where we've had conversations with the girls, and there's always some point in the conversation where I hear, well, Jared says. And so your opinion and your advice is always valued and appreciated. And the second piece that I can share is your natural ability to fit right in with our family. You have enthusiasm and humor and positivity, and it's all infectious with all of us. And so that's something that we really love about you. And you know, overall, I see the impact you have with our kids, and I appreciate that the most about you. And you've really rocked the role of Uncle Jared. So anyways, happy birthday, baby. You want to step in?
Right off the bat, happy birthday, Jared. You know, another great year. I'm so lucky I've got to get to know you, and you're part of our family, man. It's awesome. You're a really good guy, and
hope you have an awesome day.
See you again soon.
Go do some fishing.
Yeah.
So anyways, I hope you have an amazing birthday, and we wish we were there with you. But we will be together soon. I know it. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Jared.
I'm feeling it. Oh yeah. There it is. It feels like it's Jared's birthday coming up. Hold on. What is this amethyst telling me? Oh yeah. It's going to be a great year. It's going to be prosperous. Very prosperous. What else am I feeling? Harmonious.
Happy
it's
going
to be harmonious.
Happy birthday, Jared.
Happy birthday.
Bye.
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 Hey, Jared. Just have to tell you, there is life on the other side of 50. Reporting back from that other side, life is good, especially if you have amazing family the way you do with Samson and Cammie. I'm sending you lots of love for your birthday from the Eastern Shore of Maryland.
Jared Robinson. Let me tell you a secret about Jared Robinson. The man is a sweetheart. And you wouldn't know it because he's got bulletproof confidence on and off the mound. I remember watching him play. What? This isn't Jared Robinson, the minor league baseball player? The actor? Jared Robinson. Let me tell you a secret about Jared Robinson. When he first showed up on the set of the Australian soap opera Sons and Daughters, he didn't, what? What now? Oh, Jared, why didn't you just... Jared, 50? No joke, man. I feel the smile before I see you walk into the room. You light it up. Never had a lightsaber fight atop the ones we got to do over 15 years ago. It's been an honor being your dungeon master. Happy birthday, man.
Happy birthday, Jared Robinson. Happy 50th birthday, Jared Robinson. I can't believe you're 50. It's amazing how time flies. I still remember when we worked together at SPS and we played volleyball on North Avenue Beach and hit the bars afterwards. I remember it like it was yesterday. So, hope you're doing well. It's been a long time since I've seen you, though I keep up with you and your family on Facebook. Wish I could be there to, wish I could be there to celebrate your big birthday, or wish you were here so I could buy you a drink. Since I can't, I'll have a drink in your honor. A little Koval single barrel rye whiskey. It's quality stuff for a quality guy. Cheers, here's to you. Happy 50th birthday. Hope all is well, and I hope that when all this craziness is over with, that you'll come to town and I'll be able to go out with you and Scott and have a drink in person. So even though all the bars and restaurants are closed where you are, I'm sure you're still gonna find a fun and awesome way to celebrate. So happy birthday! Here's to you. Cheers.
Happy birthday, Jared. We wish we could be with you on your 50th.
Tell you the ways in which we love you.
How many ways do we love you? Let's count the ways, starting with J for Jared.
J is for joyous. Bring joy to those you love.
A is for always positive.
R is for the real deal. You are the real deal.
E is for entertaining.
T is for devoted and kind to family and friends alike.
Happy 50th. I could not be more lucky than to have a life partner like you and to have gotten to spend the last 15 years with you. Thanks for making me funnier, more grounded, more well-rounded, and just generally happier. We're so lucky to have you in our lives, and you can see how much everyone else agrees. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday. I think someone else might have something to say too.
Hi, Dad. I just wanted to wish you a happy 50th birthday. And thank you for just being there for me like all those for the last 10 years. And also, I want to be as awesome or as cool or as funny as I am right now, because without you, or as smart, or I think that's about it, but you've been a very great influence on me.
So, happy 50th!